Hey, this is Denver Riddle with Color Grading Central, and this is a 12-minute color grading crash course for Final Cut Pro 10. You'll learn how to grade in this tutorial, you'll learn the color tools, and together we'll create this really amazing look on footage you can download and follow along with. Also, I want to let you know about a free online training event I'll be doing. We'll go into even more depth, you can ask me questions, and it's free to attend. Details are below this video in the description. All right, let's do this thing. Here inside of Final Cut Pro, if you download the clips provided in the description, you'll find a few pre-trimmed clips from cinematographer and good buddy Chris McKechnie. I've also included an XML and some instructions on how to bring this footage in a Final Cut Pro 10 as an edited sequence. I thought you'd think that was pretty awesome. Now, the focus of this tutorial is on color grading, so we're going to work mainly in the color and effects workspace, and that'll bring up the inspector as well as the video scopes. And all the color tools we'll need can be accessed from right here in the inspector. It's also worth pointing out the effects panel where we can do some other things, including adding masks, but more on that in a bit. Now, before we jump in and start grading this thing, let's discuss basic terminology for how we define color. The three basic terms that we use to define color are hue, saturation, and luma. Hue is the name we call colors, saturation is the intensity or vividness of a hue, and luma is the brightness or shade of hue. It's also important to know how to read the video scopes, which can be super beneficial. I'm going to change the view to show the three scopes that I use most. And those three are the luma waveform, the RGB overlay waveform, and the vector scope. The waveform lets us correct for exposure. If I overlay an image on top of the waveform, you can see that the trace, the stuff you see here, actually corresponds with the image of the two people as they move toward each other. The RGB overlay waveform is helpful for correcting white balance issues and is read exactly the same as the luma waveform, but also shows the color channels in red, green, and blue. This makes it easier to spot imbalances if either the image is too cool or too warm. The vectorscope corresponds directly with the color wheel, and I've overlaid it here for convenience. It shows what colors are in the image as well as their saturation. The further the trace extends from the center of the scope, the more saturated or vivid the colors are. Here's a simple but powerful workflow for color correction. We first correct the exposure or brightness of the image, second, the white balance or color temperature if there are any issues, and lastly, the saturation by either increasing or reducing it. This will make more sense as we actually do it. Let's first make a correction to the exposure of this image using the color wheels. To the right of each color wheel, you'll find the exposure controls. The shadows control affects the darkest parts of the image, the highlights affects the brightest parts, and the midtones control affects everything else in between. The fourth wheel is the master control, which adjusts the entire image, and there are some circumstances where you'd use it. We'll adjust the blacks first with the shadows control while watching the waveform. We want to bring the trace and the shadows down until the darkest parts of the image sit right above zero. Then we'll bring up the highlights with the highlights control so that the brightest parts of the trace sits right about here near the top. Then let's darken the mid-range by pulling the midtones down. This will help us remove that washed out look from the talent's face. And then I'll just adjust this a little more until we have good contrast and exposure. Next, we'll fix the color temperature since the image is looking cool. Our goal here is to neutralize or white balance the whites, and we'll want to find something in the image that is white. In this case, we're going to use this part of the image as a reference and its corresponding trace in the RGB overlay waveform scope, where we can see that the blue trace is elevated above the red and green channels. Our goal here is to get these color channels to align evenly, and when they do, we'll get neutral white in the image. So I'll achieve this with the temperature control, which adjusts the color balance along the orange to blue spectrum. In this case, I'll drag it to the right, adding warm colors, and I'll keep dragging until this part of the RGB overlay waveform turns white. Lastly, let's boost the color a little bit by increasing the saturation with the control on the left side of the master wheel. And here's what the clip looks like before and after the correction. Pretty amazing, right? On the next shot, we'll repeat the same procedure, going for a nice balance of exposure with the midtones, shadows, and highlights controls. The color temperature in the shot looks good, so we can just add some saturation. Moving to the next shot, we'll want to match it to the first shot for obvious reasons, since they are different angles from the same scene. To give us a good starting point, let's copy the correction from the first clip to the second one. We'll go to the first shot, select it, and use the keyboard shortcut Command C to copy. Then we'll go back to this clip and go to the Edit menu, paste attributes, make sure that the color effect is checked, and click OK. This copies the correction and gives us a good starting point, but you'll see that we still have some matching issues. The image is way too cool, and it can use some additional contrast too. And definitely our talent's face is too dark. To help with matching, let me show you my preferred method for doing this. It's a little extra work, but it's foolproof. We'll option drag the first clip and drag it above the third clip to make a copy. We'll then go to the inspector and reduce its scale to 50% and drag the X position to the left. We're then going to do the same for the third clip, but this time positioning it to the right. Now, here's the really cool thing. In the side-by-side view, we can compare them visually and in the scopes as well, so this makes matching a breeze. To match the traces better, we'll drop the shadows with the shadows control, increase the highlights, increase the midtones, and then decrease the shadows one more time to compensate. We can now see that in the waveform, both traces look like they're at the same level. To improve the color match, I'll drag the temperature to the right to warm it up, and the tint slightly to the left, which adds a little green. Then we'll just increase the saturation. All right, that's a nice looking match. Okay, now let's disable our reference clip by clicking on it and using the keyboard shortcut V to disable it. We'll then reset the transform properties on the third clip. The face is looking a little too dark, so to brighten the talent's face for the shot, we can do that with a shape mask where we're effectively relighting the scene, something really cool that we can do. Now, in order to do this, we'll need to add another set of color wheels, which we can add from here. Then to add a mask, I'll click here and select Shape Mask. I'll then resize and position it over his face and rotate it a little to match the angle of his face. Then to brighten his face, we'll increase the midtones, and you can see when we play it back that the talent's face moves. So we'll want to address that. We'll set a position keyframe at the beginning and the end, and adjust the shape here. And bada bing, bada bang. The shape moves perfectly with the movement of our talent. In the interest of time, I've already gone ahead and finished performing corrections to these remaining clips, but let's say in this next shot, for whatever reason, the director decides that he doesn't like that the woman's hair is purple and would prefer it to be black with red highlights. Well, the cool thing is that we can do that with a color mask in Final Cut Pro 10. So we'll need to add another color wheels effect. Click here to select a color mask, and then let's click and drag to the talent's hair to qualify it. We can add a little more by holding the Shift key and dragging. You can see we're grabbing a bit of the man's clothes as well, so to further qualify this, all we have to do is add a shape mask and put it right about here, but it doesn't have to be perfect. Now, to change the color of her hair, let's add warm colors to the highlights until her hair is a bright orange color. We'll then reduce the master saturation significantly and drop the brightness in the midtones. Here's what it looks like when we play it back. Worked like a charm. Fixed it in post. Okay, now we're to the really fun part, and that's creating an awesome look for these clips. I'm going to show you a quick way to apply the same look on top of all these clips, and this will save time and ensure you have a consistent look across the board. To do that, we'll highlight all the clips, then right-click and select New Compound Clip. Now when we make a color adjustment to the compound clip, it'll apply the same correction to all the clips uniformly. Pretty sweet, huh? All right, now let's create the look. And this time, we'll do it with the color curves for added control. I can do that by selecting them here. And a quick crash course on the way this works, in case you haven't already used these in applications like Photoshop, the bottom point adjusts the shadows, the top point adjusts the highlights, and we can make as many points as we want on the curve in between to shape the tonal range. To give the contrast a soft muted look on the luma curve, we'll reduce the contrast by dragging the top point down, and then the bottom point up. I'll then make a point here and drag up to brighten the midtones, and then another point here, and then drag down to adjust the density in the shadows. Now for color, to give this a warm, sunny California look, we'll go to the blue channel and drag the top point down, subtracting blue to warm it up. Then with the bottom point, we'll drag to the right, subtracting even more blue from the shadows. Going to the red channel, we'll drag the bottom point, adding more red to warm up the shadows. And then another point here and drag down to balance the mid-tones so the skin tones aren't too red. And then another point here and drag down to create color contrast by pushing teal colors into the shadows. Finally, we'll add some saturation by adding a color board layer and increasing the overall saturation to make it pop more. To take this look even further, let's make some secondary or isolated adjustments to make elements in the scene fit better with our look. Namely, we want green to appear more yellow and blues to appear more aqua or cyan. The cool thing is that we can do this easily with the hue saturation curves. I'll add them here, and we'll work with the hue versus hue curve. We want the green grass to be a little bit more yellow, so we'll click on the eyedropper and select the grass. This will make 3 points for us here, and by dragging the middle point up, we can make the grass appear more yellow. I'd also like the blues to be more of an aqua color, so again, I can use the eyedropper clicking here, and drag this point up and to the left. Okay, now I'd like to selectively adjust the saturation. I'll switch to the hue versus sat curve and use the eyedropper again, clicking on this part of the image, then drag the middle point up to add more saturation to the teal colors. Great, here's a before and after of our hue versus hue and hue versus saturation corrections. Wow, that looks amazing. What an awesome sunny California look. If you really like this look and want to save some steps by applying this as a lookup table, you can download this as a LUT when you sign up for the live workshop event. Now, I know we covered a lot here and I skipped over a lot of details, but what I wanted to do was give you the big picture, and if you like this tutorial and you want to see more, then sign up for our free workshop event where we'll go into even more depth, we'll cover more color theory, and you can ask me questions. So to save your spot, just follow the links in the description below this video, and I promise you, it will be well worth your time and you'll get a lot better from one simple training. So I hope you enjoyed this crash course as much as I enjoyed creating it for you, and I look forward to seeing you at the training. Have a great day.